the Coach. You're locked into the NFL on EA Sports. We are moments away from kickoff, and we've got a good one on tap between the Carolina Panthers and the San Francisco 49ers. With that, let's get you out to Silicon Valley, Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara, as we welcome in our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Well, the onset of fall weather, Coach, certainly a welcome occurrence for folks in Silicon Valley, and we've got football on a gorgeous day here in Santa Clara as we are situated at Levi's Stadium. The scene a short time ago, this crowd, they love their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room, and we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with the Carolina Panthers. Hi again, everyone. Brandon Godden alongside Charles Davis. And Charles, you take a look at these 49ers as they interplay here. They've got all W's on the ledger so far, a perfect 6-0.
Yeah, still a long way to go in this season, but they're showing everyone early on that they intend to be there in the end.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Panthers, they've come in on a nice run of recent form, 4 wins out of 5. Both of these teams about to reach the halfway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. This one fielded at the 5. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Jimmy Garoppolo taking out the San Francisco 49ers onto the field, and he's got to be playing with a lot of confidence right now. This crew at 5-0, and if you remember back to his 5 starts in 2017, he won all 5 of those at the end of the year, Charles. And by the way, good stat from our main man, Ed Brady. 49er quarterbacks to win their first 5 starts of a season since 1950. Joe Montana, Jimmy Garoppolo.
That's big-time company that Jimmy Garoppolo is joining. When you're talking about the best quarterback in 49ers history, as most would say, that's big time. 13-2 lifetime as a starting quarterback in San Francisco. And this year has his team in first place in the NFC West.
Throwing now is Garoppolo. That's complete to his receiver, Pettis. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Garoppolo looks to throw. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. 4th and from the gun, Garoppolo. That's caught. It's Coleman.
A short game that doesn't get them the first down brings up a 4th down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away.
Come on, baby. Let's go.
Set, ready? 30 base.
54. Right, 54. A first carry for Christian McCaffrey, who made his first Pro Bowl last year. And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of 5. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. So 2nd down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40.
Switch.
Allen now to throw again. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line.
Here we go, here we go.
Now a man who really stepped up last year. This is Matt Breida. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Now Garoppolo on the bootleg. And this is Salek here with a grab. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. They face a third and 4 after that last completion gets him 6. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And a nice pick up there. It gets about 5 down to the 4-yard line. So we'll look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. And they tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of everyone.
And it's complete. In the end zone, touchdown 49ers. Emmanuel Sanders, his third touchdown now on the year, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Gold able to tack on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. This fielded at the 2. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. A throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete. Christian McCaffrey, last year's catch leader among running backs, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Allen throwing again. Oh, Allen cannot get away, and down he goes. Nick Bosa in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Let's get off the field.
Look at me, zipper.
On third and long, it's Allen. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. They'll wind up with 17 on that one, but they're still a bit short here for fourth. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Ready for the second quarter, and it's our visitors with the football. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. And this will depend on the mark. I'm not sure he pushed the line forward. And indeed, he did not. They stop him. So they give it up just on their side of midfield. And, yeah, I mean, a surprising decision there. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Brian Burns, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Only 3 yards on the pickup. They'll be left staring at a third and 14. Flag comes in. This might be a free play. And able to haul it in is Kittle. They knew they had the free play after the penalty. They get great yardage, so they can decline that penalty.
And one of the things we've seen develop more and more in recent years, our team seeing that penalty occur and still take
it. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Jimmy Garoppolo with his second touchdown pass of this first half. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Fielded about a yard deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Panthers offense set to get the football back. And this is a team in Carolina able to make the long flight home from London a happy one. They got the win in the second NFL game played at the new Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. But what do we make of the Panthers? We talked about... And now this is intercepted. My goodness. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. They'll run with Coleman on first down. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. Well, remember, Tevin Coleman was in the two-headed backfield in Atlanta during his 4 years there, along with Devontae Freeman. Now he joins a crowded backfield in San Francisco. But in Atlanta, he played under offensive coordinator Kyle Shanahan, and then, of course, Shanahan becomes a 49er head coach, and he made it a point to go out and snag his former running back because he really likes his 26-year-old ball carrier. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. The Niners on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And a terrific return as he brings this one all the way back to the 30.
Boy, that's the kind of interception that can save a game right there. They're already down 2 scores. Huge play, slowing down what was going against them.
I was thinking the same thing. You get down 3 scores there at this stage, could be in for a long ball game. And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25. Allen now on the option right. Pitches to McCaffrey. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. And chalk that up as a 4-yard loss. And now it's 3rd down. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. To throw, it's Allen. And he finds a man. It's McCaffrey. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Panther first down. 2 minutes to play, first half, it's 14-0. Coming up at halftime, we remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL as we reach now, hard to believe, the halfway point of the season. Time flying.
It certainly is. Time to get the sweaters out, my man.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. Give him a gain of 4, able to convert, and that sets up 1st and goal now. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. On 2nd and goal, Allen, and that'll be caught. Touchdown, Panthers, Olsen. Greg Olsen. His 3rd touchdown now on the year as they are now on the board here in the first half. Extra point splits the uprights.
I think everyone in the league talks about finishing, don't they? Doesn't matter whether it's a quarter, a half, a game, a series, whatever. But they're finishing the first half in fine style, putting that one in the end zone.
They did, and they didn't leave much time on the clock either. Well done. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. You're under a minute to go here in the half. Field position not really in your favor, but still time to try to move the ball and get in field. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. That's Luke Kuechly with a sack. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Another try after the first down sack. Garoppolo, he hits his target. It's the tight end, Toilolo. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Throwing is Garoppolo on third down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 34.
Pick six, baby. Let's get this.
Well, this was a 14-0 game not too long ago. Things were looking pretty good. Then you give up the touchdown on the last drive. Now the interception.
So that's a lesson in trying to stay vigilant, isn't it? You have to stay on top of things. Can't relax too much because, as you noted, things change. Now they've got to go out there and get a spark going again and try and slow down this comeback.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. And they've got the hookup. This is Olsen. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
Ready? 70, Indy.
Throwing on first down is Allen. Flush to his right. He's going to let it go deep. And this is going to be intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something they feel is somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go four verticals because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
Here we go. By 20!
So we've hit halftime here in Santa Clara with the 49ers out in front. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Hi again, everybody. Let's get you caught up with what's going on around the league here in the unofficial midway point, week 8 of the NFL season. We'll get started over at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta, where it was definitely a game with some intrigue, as you can see by the scoreline. Matt Ryan, 5 touchdown passes, leading his guys to the victory. From there, we head up to Foxborough to check on the Patriots at home at Gillette Stadium. And for the moment, they trail the visiting Browns in that one. The Browns try and hold on and claim victory. Finally, let's get to the country music capital of the world and see what's happening with the Titans at home in Nashville. And they were losers in that one to the visiting Tampa Bay Bucks. Peyton Barber, 2 touchdown runs to lead the way. In the game you're watching, it was Jimmy Garoppolo who was brilliant in that first half. His guys have the lead as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A 1 touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. And he's looking to take much better care of the football here in half 2 after 3 first half interceptions.
We don't have to just look strictly at the numbers here. You know what else happens to a team when you turn it over 3 times like that? It erodes confidence in you. And it erodes confidence in the offense. And now you have the defensive guys looking over and saying, what is going on here? And instead of playing for the team, they're playing angry and mad at their teammates.
And the tackle there by Quan Alexander. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made. And that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. They'll try and pick it up in McCaffrey. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. They're losing here. And now on fourth and one, it's a fake. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. Anxious moments there on the fake, but they do get just enough to pick up the first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a shotgun handoff to Scarlett. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play there. Second down. And now they'll throw with Allen. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
To the air, Allen. And he fires one, but incomplete. Well, it appears they're going to come up empty on this first drive of the second half, still down by that slim margin.
Yeah, and that's okay. You know, when you sit and analyze it, they're not happy about what happened, having to go to the bench. But this gives them a chance to let their defense do some work while they, on the sidelines, go over what they're doing offensively and formulate a proper plan. That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
He's crossing. He's checking. Crossing.
On second down, a run with Breida. They'll try to get forward, but he's going to be stopped in his tracks at about the 3. James Bradbury there to make the tackle. Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
They'll run it down with Juszczyk. And he's not going to get anywhere close to the marker as they'll stop him well short of the yellow line. It'll be a gain of 5, and the punt team will now come out on 4th down.
And that's why the fullback position was created. You just want a big, strong, powerful guy you can hand the ball to and pick up good yardage.
That's taken at around the 40. 49-yard punt, 5 on the return. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
60 Pittsburgh.
54. Switch up. Switch it.
Throwing on 2nd and 8. Allen and Thomas has it. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down.
And, partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. An effective 7-yard third down conversion. On first down, this is McCaffrey. It's a good pickup on the ground of 7 yards, and time has run out on this 3rd quarter. Back now here in Santa Clara. It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here as we get to the 4th and final quarter of play. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again, and he'll get 3 down of the 34-yard line. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there. Brandon, unfortunately, I've been here before. They've had 2 opportunities to stop them, so this is demoralizing. They haven't gotten it done. Now you're calling all your blitzes, all your attack defenses, but you're not worried about playing your normal position. You're going to take chances now.
Well, you said it. 2 third down opportunities to get off the field. Couldn't do it, and the clock continues to roll. 13 yards, first down, Panthers. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's 1st and 10. Here's Allen. A quick throw, but incomplete. fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now on third down, that pass knocked down in the backfield and incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
So an interesting call there to take the three. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 12-yard line. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. It's caught by Sanders. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. 25 yards that time.
Here we go.
Well, it may seem a little unorthodox to some people. Got the lead, fourth quarter, yet he's still firing away. I think he believes that's the best way to go ahead and win the game.
Yeah, a lot of coaches say, let's just run the football, be conservative. He's sticking to his game plan.
No, that is his game, and that's what they're going to run.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. To throw is Garoppolo. That's complete to a speedy wideout Goodwin. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. Garoppolo now 11 of 16 through the air. It's first and 10. Garoppolo going to hand this one to Coleman. Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Pettis hauling this in from Garoppolo. Well, Pettis is quickly becoming the number one receiving option for Jimmy Garoppolo. Into last year, John Lynch said that they loved the way he closed the season. Really came on late. Remember, this is a guy that they traded up to get at number 44 back in 2018 out of the University of Washington. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. On first down, Coleman. And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17. That was play number seven on this drive, and it got him 7 yards. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Kind of a fine line when you're setting up the screen. You don't want to throw it too early and have the defense react too quickly. And you definitely don't want to throw it too late. And that way it's not formed perfectly. Got to make sure you hit it just right.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Matt Breida, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So now the Panthers down by 11, and time, a huge factor. Their four-game winning streak in great danger. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target, and it's second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in.
Let's go, get set.
23 yards, the pickup there. First down, and they're going to throw it down.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Back to the air on second down. It's Allen. Oh, Allen cannot get away, and down he goes. DeForest Buckner in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up in that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Clock rolling here. About to hit 30 seconds. Allen going to throw. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. Whether it's a touchdown or a field goal, whatever it is, they need to score quickly here on first down. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. He started out having some troubles back in the first half connecting with his receivers. Really hasn't gotten a whole lot better.
Yeah, he's at less than 50%, and you and I both know that just won't do. So I would think about spreading things out, putting it on the receivers, make them win those one-on-one battles on the perimeter and find their way open.
Now here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. And he is into the end zone for the touchdown. So they still need a miracle with a clock where it's at, but they get one piece to the puzzle done.
Still have hope.
I'm not sure
win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though. Now this one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
So the victory here for San Francisco, and it wasn't really always pretty. They had their bumps and bruises, really both sides did, but they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind this one out, didn't they? Because nothing came easy. Every snap was a major league brawl. They had to win at the line of scrimmage, win downfield. They got all those things accomplished, but to win a close one like this, you know, every team wants to be physical. We've heard that a million times, right? But those who are mentally tough, those are the teams that you have to deal with in the playoffs. This was that type of a game.
So for San Francisco, their winning ways continue as they get it up to 7.